In the part one screencast, we developed the equations that we will now solve numerically to determine the size of a plug flow reactor for 50% conversion of reactant A, and we're given the various information about the feed and the rate of reaction here. And the equations were developed in part one. Now let's look at how we would write a polymath program to solve those equations. So I've opened the polymath program and selected the differential equation solver, and then I put in a comment. So the number sign, anything following that line, is a comment. So isothermal plug flow reactor. And then what I want to do is I'm going to put in the mass balance for A. So one way to do it is to select, for entering differential equations, molar flow rate of A, spec to the volume, and that's going to be equal to R sub A. And the initial value, I have to have a numerical value here, so I've calculated the numerical value, 1.858, and that's 20% of the total inlet flow rate. And if I want, I could put a comment like mole balance on A. And I'm done. It shows up in the correct format, as well as the format for initial conditions. So now I can just type in the differential equation. I can do it either way. And this is, because of the stoichiometry, 2 times R sub A. And likewise, I can put in differential equation and initial conditions for C. So let me pause and just add those in. So now I've added the initial condition for B and differential equation for D with its initial condition, and then the rate of reaction expression. And again, for some of these I put comments. The next thing I need to do is add the starting and stopping values for the integration. Here the initial value of V is 0. And the final value is what I'm solving for. Since I've already solved the equation, I know approximately, well, I know exactly the answer. I'm going to say, I'm going to integrate to around 30. So when I wouldn't know, easiest thing is to put a value in, check the answer, and because it's fast to solve it, I can just change it to get as accurate an answer as I want. So it's going to integrate from V equals 0 to 30. Of course, what I'm going to do is solve for the conversion. So I've added the conversion and written in terms of FA 0 and put again in its numerical value. Now let me add the parameters. So I've added the parameters, and again I've added some comments indicating the units for the parameters. And the final thing is the algebraic equations that relate volumetric flow rates to concentrations and total molar flow rates, and how the volumetric flow rate changes as the molar flow rate changes. So again, these are just algebraic equations. I'm going to copy them in. They're developed in the part one screencast. So I've added the equations for concentration and total molar flow rate, and also added some comments. And now you'll notice up here that I have the arrow purple indicating that everything is there that is needed to solve the equation. So let's solve it, and let's get a table output instead of a report so we can get a good idea of what value of volume we get a conversion of 50%. What I'm interested in is the value of X, so I can just scan down in the table, and you'll notice that X is at conversion of 0.499 for a volume of 28.8 liters, and so that's as accurate as our original data justifies, so 50% conversion at 28.8 liters. And I could also, of course, ask Polymath to give me a graphical output. So I could ask for a graph instead of a table, or in addition to the table, let's just look at a graph. And what I'm interested in is plotting X. I can look at various things, but for now, let's just look at X as a function of volume. And you'll notice that volume 28.8 is where we get 50% conversion. And of course, the table just gives the information more accurately. It's very rapid to use polymath to solve sets of ordinary differential equations.